My research is on plant viruses and how they interact with plants. Most of these viruses are transmitted by insects, and the most important insect vector of these viruses are aphids, or more commonly known as green fly. One of the problems is that farmers have great difficulty controlling the viruses, stopping them infecting the plants, and the main way they try to do this is by spraying lots of pesticides onto crops. So the focus, or the main thrust of our research, has been to try and identify natural plant resistances that can be incorporated into plant varieties so that the farmers don't have to spray so many pesticides on their crop. We were working on plant resistance, but without knowing a lot about the viruses themselves, then you're not going to make a lot of progress in terms of resistance. So we started identifying sources of resistance to the virus we were working on, and eventually we came across a source of resistance that appeared to be a much more broad spectrum. Now, this resistance was very different to these dominant resistances. It was as a recessive form of resistance. We did a lot of research on that recessive source of resistance, and we found that it was controlled by a novel mechanism, and we're also able to identify the gene that controlled that resistance. And the university decided they wanted to patent that, and we eventually entered into a collaboration with a very large plant breeding company, Syngenta. Syngenta were able to integrate this resistance into their commercial plant varieties. Being in Warwick allowed me to expand into that international research environment, and of course our excellent glasshouse facilities, growth chamber facilities, and again colleagues and collaborators at Warwick.